So if I understand your problem correctly, so you want the solution for these two statements. So 20 by 58 is 34 of 100%. Then what by what is what percentage of 80? Am I right in saying that? Okay. In order to solve this particular problem, what I'm doing is I'm going to use the solver utility in Microsoft Excel. So solver helps us in determining the variable values based on a formula. You can identify two variables, single variable, or three variables in this particular case. So what I've done is I've identified four variables here, X, Y, Z, and I. So you can consider this as maybe A. So X represents 20, Y represents 58, Z represents 34, and I is the formula that we have used here based on this particular condition that we have, which is, I'll just copy it and write it here. So this is the formula that we are using here. So it is 20 by 58 times 100 minus 34. It should be zero in our case, right? So let's say if the value of A is 100, which is B6, and if I make it 20, if I make it 58, and if I make it 34, so it becomes zero. This is the formula that we have that we currently have. Now, in case I make it 80, we want the values for these three variables, and our value of I should become zero in that case as well. So I'll just remove it here. Okay. So I'm going to use 2, 3, and 4 random variables. Okay. And now I'm going to use a solver utility here. So you go to data and you go to solver here. So we need to understand that there are three or four different things in solver which we need to clearly understand. What is first is set your objective. In our case, our objective is the value of B5 cell, it should be equal to zero, right? And what do we want to change? We want to change the values of cell B2, B3 and B4. So that's why I've mentioned B2, B3 and B4 here. And there is no constraint as such because we have already given the value of B6 as 80. That is the desired state that we really want to do. So I'm not making any changes and make unconstrained variables non-negative or selecting a solving method. I'm just clicking on solve here. So it's trying different solutions for us. So this is one of the solutions that a solver has found. Okay, but this is not the desired result probably that we are looking forward to. So I'm going to change the value somewhat here and let's run the solver once again. Let me just go here and let's get rid of the iterations. Okay, and then run it once again. Okay, so this is the solver says that solver has found a solution. All constraints and optimality conditions are being satisfied. And we are going to click on OK. Now, these are the desired values for us, 17, 37, 36. So 17 by 37 is 36 of 80. I hope this answers your query. Thank you.